How to stream in VR for PCVR. Step 1. Pick a broadcasting software. I personally use Streamlabs OBS. For the sake of this video, I will be using standard OBS because it's less taxing on your computer, and unless your computer is God mode, you will probably be wanting to use OBS. Regardless of which one you guys decide to use, they are both incredibly similar, so this guide will help you set up both of them. Step 2. Set up your broadcasting software. This stuff has become incredibly simple since when I started doing it, so a lot of it is pretty straightforward. For the most part, you can just use their recommended settings, but this will come down to how strong your computer is. Streaming VR is incredibly hard because your computer is basically rendering games and programs 2 to 3 times just so you can play them on your screen, one for each eye and one for the monitor. The better quality your stream is, the less people's eyes will bleed when they try to watch it, which will usually keep them around a bit longer. Streamlabs and OBS now do have a Connect Account button, which allows you to just directly connect the account to your program on your computer, which is amazing. If you don't want to do this method, you can still use the old method of typing in your stream key, which you can find on whichever platform you are using. There are a million guides on how to set up Streamlabs and OBS, so I'm not going to go into huge details here, but I'm going to go into a couple of the basics for you. This is the main window for OBS. The black square in the middle is going to be where your stream is showing your game or whatever window you're capturing once we get that set up. At the bottom left, you have the scenes. To the right of that, you have your sources, your audio, and then your options to go live. If you are following along with Streamlabs OBS, you'll notice that this screen looks almost identical. To get started capturing a window, we're going to first want to create a scene that can be recalled later so we don't have to make a new one every single time we open the program. Having multiple scenes allows you to easily transition between things like your live scene and maybe an intermission screen or even an intro that you have before your stream goes live. The first thing I like to do is just rename and label things properly so I know exactly what this scene is going to do, and then I can start adding the sources. To add a source, click the plus below the sources box, and it should pop up with a window that asks which type of source you would like to create. I will go over a couple of them for you. For the most part, you want to try to make this as accurate as possible, as the more accurate you are, the less your computer will have to work, and therefore the better your stream quality can be. Display capture or monitor capture is the simplest form of capture. It will capture everything that is on whichever display that you select. And I do mean everything, so make sure you check which windows are minimized in the background. Now, this is also the option that will make your computer run the hardest, so keep that in mind when you're selecting one. Game capture and window capture are probably going to be your other two main ones. Game capture primarily for games, imagine that. And window capture primarily for capturing specific windows or for that sweet Microsoft Excel gameplay. For the sake of this video, I'm going to go ahead and just do display capture because I'm lazy. After selecting display capture, it asks which monitor you want to record. I select which one I want, which is my main monitor, and then I hit OK. After you create the source, it should appear in the little box at the bottom. There are two icons next to it, an eyeball and the lock. The eyeball, if you click that, it will show or hide the source. So if you want to hide a specific source, you can just click the eyeball to get rid of it. And the lock will make it so you can't accidentally move it around or mess with it. Another note is you can make as many sources as you want, but whichever one is at the top of the list will take priority above all of the rest of them, just like a window being brought to the forefront. Now, when playing a VR game on PCVR, a window will pop up. You can just capture that window. What I'm going to show you guys now is how I capture my view from SteamVR to actually show both of my eyes at high quality. If you guys have tried to watch VR FPS games before, you know that some people do not even capture the correct eye when they're streaming, so it doesn't even look like they're aiming their gun. I'm going to show SteamVR first, and then I'm going to show a couple tips for Oculus further in the video. The last thing for both platforms that I want to address is in the settings for OBS. There's a million different settings that you can change, but the one that you should look at is video bitrate. Video bitrate is how quick your computer tries to upload to whichever streaming platform you're using. The default is 2500 kilobytes per second, and this does change with how fast your internet speed is. If you are on a slower connection, leave this number low so your computer and internet can try to keep up with it. If you have incredibly fast internet, you can up this number to 4 to 6K just so you can have better overall streaming quality. So let's get into step three, setting up SteamVR. Now the way that I do this is a little bit more taxing on your computer, but the quality will be worth it if your computer can handle it. The first thing that you're going to want to do is go ahead and get your headset ready and then start SteamVR. Once SteamVR is running, navigate to the taskbar at the bottom of your screen, go to the system tray at the bottom right, right-click SteamVR and hit Display VR View. Selecting this will open a window that will display exactly what is on your VR headset. And this is another, it will display everything on your headset, so be careful exactly what you're looking at in VR. On your computer, if you right-click the VR view, you're able to select left eye, right eye, both eyes, or dominant eye. The way that I normally have mine set up is both eyes, left dominant. I select left dominant because I aim with my left eye. If you use your right eye to aim, select right dominant. This will display a wider field of view for all viewers watching. There is a little bit of distortion on one part of the screen depending on which eye you have selected. So on mine, you can see the little painting is a little bit distorted, but it's hardly noticeable unless you're looking for it. The VR view on your computer is listed under window capture, so instead of using display capture, if you want to be able to save on CPU usage and performance, set this up as a window capture instead. It will still work just the same and be a little faster. And these are all of the steps you need to get started with streaming with SteamVR. From here, you can add text, you can add other windows, you can add sub notifications. I'm not going to go into details on all of those, but as a final tip, I will show you how to look at your chat while you're in VR. SteamVR just had an awesome update, which makes actually grabbing your chat incredibly easy. To do this, press the SteamVR menu button on your controller. On the index, it's the small button. You're going to click on Desktops at the bottom, which will actually pull up a desktop window that you can look at. You can add a view, and from here, you can actually add a desktop view from any window that's on your computer. The easiest thing you can do is just select OBS to show that on the main display. I personally use a program called HexChat because it allows me to hear a little notification ding when someone sends a message, which is awesome for me because I always forget to check chat. And then at the bottom of this next window, you have an option to dock on controller. You can dock this to your left or right controller, and then after you do so, it will allow you to resize and move it around. For a lot of FPS games, I end up putting this facing down underneath my controller, which is actually invisible if I'm not looking at it. But for other games that aren't second-to-second combat, like Beat Saber, you can actually leave it on that window and just check it between songs. And those are all the steps I have for you guys to get things set up on SteamVR. Remember, with the window selection, you can just capture OBS itself, or if you want to use Google Chrome that has a pop-out of your chat, you can do that as well. But I will now get to the Oculus side of things. Once you have OBS set up, go ahead and open Oculus, and we're going to navigate to the main Oculus folder. If you don't know where that is, you can go to Settings and then General, and it'll tell you which folder you need to go to. As you can see as an example on mine, I'm going to C, Program Files, Oculus, and Software, and you'll be navigating to this through the File Explorer. Now this part's only actually necessary if you want to directly capture what's being shown on your VR goggles. If your computer isn't very powerful, it's still going to be more worthwhile to just capture the window for whatever game you're playing. Once you navigate to your Oculus folder, go to Support and then Oculus Diagnostics. Now inside this folder, there should be an application called Oculus Mirror. Opening this will, just like SteamVR, open a window that displays whatever's on your Oculus headset. Now there are all sorts of settings that you can change here. At the top, if you go to Settings and Eye, you can actually change which eye you want it to record. This is awesome for VR content since there are so many creators that are actually streaming the wrong eye, so here's how you can actually fix that issue. And then the last thing that I'll show you guys is how to grab your chat window. So on your Oculus dashboard, you can select Add a Desktop Panel, and then while highlighting that panel, if you grab your grip and your trigger, you can actually pull that window out and put it somewhere. Once you've gotten that window, which you can resize by using the thumbstick to make it different sizes, make it smaller, kind of rotate where it's at. Once you have the window where you want it, there's an actual pin icon at the bottom right of the panel, and you can pin it to your actual view. So if you actually are in game or you're doing anything, you can still see the window. Now you can grab any of the windows, you could grab OBS, you could have your own specific chat program that you have and you can pin any of those programs. I would personally recommend trying to find a non-intensive chat window instead of using OBS itself, just so your computer isn't working any harder. At this time, I am unsure if you can directly pin the window to your hand. I do not actually use Oculus very much. When I was playing games, I would often put the window right below me since that was a spot that I didn't normally have to look. If you are playing a game like Beat Saber, you can actually put this window above the song or to the right or left, and you can make sure to check it between songs. Where you put this window will completely come down to where you want it and depending on what game you're playing. If you do want people to be able to see when you're looking at your chat and to actually see the window on your screen, make sure you are using that VR Oculus mirror. If you don't want them to be able to see your chat, they will just kind of see you looking at your wrist or wherever you put the chat window. Just make sure you are capturing the game window itself. So there are all of the steps and the tips that I have for you guys for getting this set up on SteamVR and on Oculus VR. Now your personal stream is going to be your brand, so whatever additional sources or things that you add in your stream will definitely attract different viewers. A lot of people know me because I have my actual VR chat avatar in the corner. Which other sources, donations, graphics, text, whatever you decide to use on your stream will help grow your brand. I personally will put a link to Suva, which is the program that I use to actually show my avatar in the corner, and there are a couple tutorials for that. But as for this video, guys, that's all I actually had for you. I hope this video helped you out. If it did help you out or you liked the video, make sure to give it a like. If you want to see more Population 1 content or are interested in more VR content, hit that subscribe button. It helps me out a ton and I will love you forever. I did just recently lose my job, so this video is kind of a test to see whether or not content creation is something that I can actually make work for me. I do also try to stream almost daily on Twitch, Population 1 and other VR games, so if you're interested in checking out more of my particular content, make sure to check me out there. As of right now, I'm sure you guys are aware that VR content creators are very few and far between, and a lot of the streams are kind of low quality. I hope this video will help start to get some of those people off the ground and start providing higher content in general. VR and VR content creation is still in the very, very early stages of everything, so I hope this video can start to help kickstart a lot of content creators and get them on their feet. If you guys have any questions, make sure to leave a comment down below. I'll try to respond to all of them and help get all of you guys started with this so we can help grow together.
Sleepy Joe and Dead Inside gonna try and get a res off potentially on the other side. Sumatchi making sure that they can't. Quicko now. Oh, Sumatchi gets the 11 kill. He gets another one. He takes out a whole team, a team wipe with a GT11. He's gonna go for two. Sleepy Joe pushes up on him. Sumatchi finds another. That's four in a row. Sumatchi getting shot at. He's got that katana shield. Toyko takes down Dead Inside and Vortex.
That's it. They come on with a huge round. That could very well be the round lead.